Let's meet our contestants. She is defined by the strength of her character, her pursuit of personal and professional fulfillment, and her implicit beauty. These qualities comprise the essence of each Mrs. Utah America contestant and our Miss Utah for America. Before we get to the swimsuit competition, we want to take a few minutes to tell you about the official philanthropic organization of Mrs. America and Miss for Utah, for America. The Victoria's Voice Foundation. David and Jackie Siegel lost their daughter, Victoria, to a drug overdose at just 18 years old. Through their tragedy, the Siegels have devoted themselves to shining a light on the opioid crisis that affects more than 24 million Americans over the age of 12. The Victoria's Voice Foundation is taking aim at reducing drug experimentation, addiction, and overdose death. You will have an opportunity tonight to contribute to this organization later on during our state costume competition. Now, I'd like to take a moment introduce you to the women behind the scenes that have made this whole event possible. Please welcome Jennifer Hunsaker and Diane Ritter. As the Mrs. America pageant celebrates its 43rd anniversary, the judges use the swimsuit competition to further evaluate each contestant's commitment to health and fitness. Each portion of the competition counts for 25% of each contestant's total score. First, to show how it's done, let's welcome Robin Tal to the stage. Chopsticks that offers free photography tutorials. She and her husband Dan went drag racing on their first date with her parents. Together, they have two daughters. Thank you, Brittany. Mrs. Lehigh, Nicole Hansen. Nicole is a real estate agent, investor, and an independent consultant chemist. She is the mastermind behind the YouTube channel Service in Motion, which shows just how much joy can be found in losing yourself to the service of others. Nicole and her husband Tad are the proud parents of one-year-old Lucy. Thank you, Nicole. Mrs. Ogden, Jennifer Stanga. Jennifer is in the process of completing her Master of Social Work from the University of Denver. She loves dance, running, yoga, traveling, and reading, and just completed the Zion's Half Marathon a few weeks ago. She and her husband, Andrew Stanga, are the proud parents of two children. Thank you, Jennifer. Mrs. Provo, Jennifer Goldsberry. Jennifer and her husband Robert have been married for 1 year. She currently works as a radio and podcast producer while actively pursuing a degree in communication studies with minors in Japanese and Italian. In fact, she worked at a news, television, and radio station in Siena, Italy after studying Italian for just 5 months. Thank you, Jennifer. Mrs. Riverton, Alicia Staggs. Alicia and her husband Trent have been married for 11 years and have two children. Alicia loves to dance. Not only does she teach at the local junior college, she was the high school drill team coach for 17 years. When asked what the most important element of a successful marriage is, Alicia replied, communication. We need to be able to share our feelings, desires, concerns, and memories with one another. Thank you, Alicia. Soraya says that being a single mom to her son Xander was one of the defining moments of her life, helping her understand the importance of teaching him compassion and integrity. Thank you, Soraya. This is South Valley, Jessica Stebbing. Jessica works as a realtor with the Bones Adams. Her hobbies and talents include crafting, martial arts, theater, and shower karaoke. Me too. She and her husband Chase have been married a year and a half and fell in love on Earth World. Jess enjoys volunteering with Salt Lake Animal Services, racing her dogs to the top of the stairs in the house, and playing t-ball with her tiny human grand. Thank you, Jessica. This is Utah County, Michelle Rutherford. Michelle and her husband Scott have been married for 23 years and have six children. In addition to achieving the status of diaper-changing ninja, master schedule juggler, and carpool stuntwoman, she is a PADI certified scuba diver. To this day, she gets nervous descending into the water. But once she's there, she's grateful for the breathtaking beauty below the surface. Thank you, Michelle. This is your Oshkosh, Camille Bauer Calderwood. Camille is a motivational speaker and YouTuber for her channel, our small party of nine, caring for her cancer warrior, Clint, as he fought and eventually lost his battle with bone cancer. Camille keenly understood that love belongs at the center of everything we do. Since marrying her husband, Cody, the cancer widower herself, she has been able to put that love into action as they raise their seven children together. Thank you, Camille. Let's bring our first group of contestants back out one more time for the judges. Successfully captured the hearts of young men. Please welcome Mrs. Utah America 2018, Robin Towle.
Mrs. Arizona United States 2000. welcome Brett Nelson.
And volunteers, a whole team of support to put on an event of this magnitude. We'd like to take this opportunity to thank the amazing people who helped make this experience so special. Our sponsors, Whimsy Clothing and Accessories, Ypsilon Dresses, The Posy Place, 24 Hour Fitness, All Things Crowned, Ulta Beauty, Hidden Crown Hair Extensions, Megan Nelson of Sigil Photography, Urban Retreat Spa and Salon, Glymed, Glam Squad, Aesthetica, and Even Stevens. And our volunteers, Adam Hunsaker, Stephanie Spar, Peyton Ashby, Brianna Taylor, and Jenna Taylor. And our Mrs. Utah America former title holder, Janine Markwitson, Starla Stanley, Jackie Thompson, Tammy Waite, Natalie Murray, and Brittany Hollinshead. Thank you so much to everyone who contributes to the Mrs. Utah America pageant. So one of our favorites and one of the crowd favorites at Mrs. America is the state costume competition, where each lady creates a costume that best represents her state. We wanted to give our ladies an opportunity to show off their creativity in our own state costume competition. While this portion of the competition is not judged by our panel, you will have an opportunity to pick the winner during intermission. But first, welcome back to the stage, our contestants.
Chemical traits of this state's favorite element, copper, in the Utah Copper Mine.
Utah's greatest landmark, the Great Salt Lake.
Bring all our contestants back out for one final look, shall we?
Could we please sing happy birthday to Miss Jennifer?
Here we go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
In the lobby, there are a series of jars next to each contestant's photo. If you liked their costume, put a few dollars in the jar. If you'd like a receipt for your contribution, or you'd like to contribute more than you have in your wallet, our volunteers will have a credit card reader standing by and can give you an electronic receipt for your donation. All proceeds will go directly to Victoria's Voice. The contestant whose costume raises the most money at the end of the night will win a special award later in the evening. Now, we're going to have a 20-minute intermission for you to cast your votes. Welcome back. Traditionally, the evening gown competition has been the most beautiful part of the show, and ours is no exception. Remember, evening gown counts for the final 25% of each contestant's score. Please join us in welcoming Mrs. Utah, Robin Tao, and our contestants in the evening gown competition.
We may be right.
Mrs. Provo, Jennifer Goldsberg. stage our first group of contestants. So it's time to figure out, in their own words, what our contestants have to say for our evening gown question. Mrs. Cash Valley, Becky. If you were selected to be Mrs. Utah, what message would you like to share with the state?
If I were selected to be Mrs. Utah, I would like to share with the state that they have absolutely amazing women and daughters. My platform is to redefine what beauty is. The world is constantly bombarding women with what superficial beauty means, but true beauty is found deep within. And I train that on a daily basis, and I have truly seen lives change when young girls find that beauty. And I would love the chance to empower their mothers so that they can be a continual example in their lives.
Mrs. Davis, how are you? You have a passion for working with the multicultural youth in Utah. Tell us what drives that passion.
Growing up a woman of color here in the state of Utah hasn't been the easiest thing for me. And when my family and I relocated here from Las Vegas in October, I knew that there was something that needed to be done to change the rhetoric. We had to change it to make it a more positive environment, because right now there's a battle amongst races. People aren't understanding their value and what stands behind their culture and that that's what makes them great. And I want the youth to see that, and I want as many people to see that as I possibly can. So, thank you.
Mrs. Lake. You are using your talents in photography to help young children find their focus. Tell us more about this program.
The program I work with is called Focus of a Child, and what we aim to do is give children a voice through photography. We know that art as a medium is empowering to youth. It encourages them to stay in school. It gives them better grades. So really focusing on the children and the arts is important, and I happen to share my love of photography with those around me, and I think it's an amazing medium that kids can pick up easily with or without disabilities. It's an amazing program. And that's what I aim to do as Mrs. Utah this year.
Thank you. Mrs. Lehigh. Your YouTube channel, Service in Motion, has brought a new face to the power of service. What was the driving force behind that?
So, I feel like a lot of things I've learned in my life are familiar. And this one, I think, came from a failure on my husband's part and I to focus on other people. We were very set to grab for our own lives our businesses that we were running and trying to be successful. And we spent a lot of time working on that and weren't putting as much effort outward. And so we decided that we needed a change in lifestyle. So it's more than just a platform for me. It's a way of life for me and my family.
Thank you. Mrs. Ogden. Your program, Ally for Survivors, is near and dear to your heart. Tell us more about the program and why you are so passionate about it.
I'm very passionate about my platform, Ally for Survivors, because as a domestic violence survivor, it is so important for me to ensure the safety for other men and women that experience domestic violence. And if one person can avoid the negative effects of domestic violence, then the experience that I had would be totally worth it. And as Mrs. Utah, I would love the opportunity to be able to go to different parts of Utah and navigate through the government system, just like I have as Mrs. Ogden, to continue to spread awareness of domestic violence and how to prevent it. Thank you.
Thank you, Jennifer. Mrs. Miller. You are passionate about oral storytelling. Why is this cause so near and dear to your heart?
It's near and dear to my heart because it has hugely benefited me. It's almost like a meditation for me, whereas when you listen to somebody tell a story and you visualize it in your head, it's a break from the day-to-day stress. I think every Utah deserves a little mental break. Thanks.
Thank you. Let's have one more round of applause for our first group of contestants. Thank you, ladies. Let's have our second group of contestants come out on the stage, please. Mrs. Riverton.
Riverton.
Your program, Be Aware, Show You Care, is designed to encourage everyone to serve others with kindness. Why do you feel this is so important in today's world?
Well, in today's society, we have many people that are suffering through depression, suicidal thoughts, and those that may have fear of missing out just from social media. I feel that this campaign, which is a friendship campaign, could actually help others be kind to one another by simply saying hello to a stranger in the grocery store or a simple smile. You would be amazed at what a simple gesture could do to someone's life. Thank you.
Thank you. This is Salt Lake City. Your favorite mottos is, life happens for you, not to you. Share where that comes from and what that means to you.
That comes through life experiences. I believe that I want to empower everyone, and once they realize that everything we're going through right now, whether it's good, bad, it's happening for a reason. We all have had a bad day, a great day, but at the end of the day, it's happening for a reason. We may not know why now, but we will end up knowing eventually.
This is South Valley. Your organization, Commission a Cause, is meant to connect businesses and charities with similar core values. Tell us why this is an important platform to you.
As Mrs. Utah, it is important to reach many people and more people and then some more people across the state. In order to do that, it's important to create a strong networking platform where businesses and multiple nonprofit organizations can work together to create that symbiotic relationship where the momentum from this year will continue to next year and to next year, and more people will be involved.
Yes. Mrs. Utah County. Are passionate about preventing child abuse through education and online resources. What drives this passion?
There's so many things that drives this passion because it's impacted so many people that I love. My platform is Defend Innocence. Defend innocence against child sexual abuse. You see,
See, through my work, I empower parents and caregivers to protect children from child sexual abuse through online resources and through education. I am and I will continue to keep this message in the forefront. I proudly partner with Prevent Child Abuse Utah and Defend Innocence. We provide education and training for parents. I also partner with the Unique Foundation. We offer hope and healing for survivors. This epidemic is impacting our state emotionally, physically, socially, and economically to the tune of $1 billion every single year. It's simply unacceptable. We have to do more and we have to make a change. And I invite you, please, join me in this cause because I will never stop caring for or protecting any child or any injured soul that my path encounters. Thank you.
This is awesome.
Positivity and kindness is born out of your personal struggles. Tell us why this message is so important to you.
Message of hope, positivity, and kindness comes straight from my heart. My husband, late husband, was diagnosed with bone cancer, and it was a four-year battle. It was every 3 months a surgery. In those 4 years, he had 12 surgeries, and people started asking, how can you guys smile? Like, how can you go on? Like, how can you live your life and still be happy when your husband has a terminal cancer diagnosis? And they wanted to know our secret. And as a motivational speaker, sharing our message of hope and light, I love to share my secrets that I've learned, that each day is a gift. Each breath that each one of us take, even if it's a horrible day, we are lucky to take it. And I know those messages, those brownies and the cinnamon rolls, you know who I'm talking about, have brought to my house on surgery days, and my kids, just our hearts were so full of love for all the kind acts that we received. And so 6 months ago, as Mrs. Wasatch, I started the kindness campaign, and nominations every month, me and my cute seven amazing little kids went and delivered stuff throughout our community. And as Mrs. Utah, I would love to continue to share the kindness campaign, and that every kind act matters, and that hope, no matter how hard your day is, through grief, loss, remarriage, blending a family with a lot of kids, that happiness is there if you choose to see it, if you choose to find it, if you choose to look at it. And I love to share my secrets that I've learned because life is a class. And I'm honored to be a motivational speaker and be able to share my life with you guys.
Let's have one more round of applause for the second group. Thank you, ladies. In just a few minutes, we will announce our top five contestants. That much closer to crowning our next Mrs. Utah American. We needed a microphone. So, Danielle.
Hi.
Is that on?
No, oh, how about it? Should I just yell really loud? Hi.
So, what is it that you would like to accomplish and share as Miss Ogden?
Well, hopefully eventually get the crown of Miss Utah. But what I'd like to share from my platform is spreading awareness for multiple sclerosis. It's a disease near and dear to my heart.
choose that?
My mother was diagnosed when I was a little girl, and just seeing her be so resilient and get through life as if nothing was different about her than the next healthy person next to her, it was just so inspirational, and I think she just battles a battle every day that I will never understand, and the least I can do is help spread awareness for people in her position.
It's... yes.
Yes, I knew. Thank you.
Thank you, Danielle. So we'd like to take a moment now and recognize members of the armed forces, past and present, that are in our audience. Would you please stand and take a moment so we can recognize you, please? Judges, are we ready? Nope. Anybody know any good dad jokes? Yeah? Who's got the best dad joke?
Yeah, you're standing up there.
Nobody? Right there. You know a dad joke? Come up here and tell us your dad joke. Come on. Come here. All right. What's your name?
Gary.
All right. Tell us your joke.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Europe.
Europe who? Wait, I know one. Knock, knock. I eat mop. Thank you. We can do more dad jokes, judges. Another one. All right. Let's see. Oh, over there. Let's see. Glasses?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, always clean with the dad jokes, everybody.
All right. How do you find Will Smith in the snow? You look for Fresh Prince. Don't miss Salt Lake. I thought we were going to be in trouble there. Judges, are you ready? One more joke. We got somebody from that side. Way back there, I see someone in a white shirt. Yeah. You're gonna like disappear behind this thing. Come over here. Okay, take the mic. What's your name?
Kate.
Hi, Kate. Tell us your joke.
Knock, knock.
Another knock, knock joke. Who's there?
Nanya.
Nanya who?
Nanya, your business.
I think we should have one more. Who else has one? Like a red shirt. Yeah. Come on up here. What's your name?
Michaela.
Michaela. You're not a dad, right? So how do you know dad jokes? Do you have a dad? Okay, I shouldn't have asked that. Sorry about that. All right, tell us your joke.
The ultimate dad joke of all time. My dad tells me this every single day. I say, Dad, I'm hungry. He said, I'm hungry, I'm dad.
That is the dad joke of all time. My kids know that one. Let's see what the judges say if they want more. They keep saying one more. All right, one more. Let's see, second from the end. Yes, you just stood up. Come on up. Come over here so everybody can see. You have stage fright? Don't have stage fright. What's your name?
Delilah.
Delilah. Ooh, I love the Delilah. I love the color in your hair, Delilah. All right, what's your joke? It's marker. Ooh. That's what kids do when dads don't let them color their hair, huh? Yeah. Your dad's cool. I believe you. All right, tell us your joke.
Okay.
Who's there?
Orange.
Orange? Who?
Orange, you glad I'm your dad?
I like it. I like it, Delilah. Thank you. We're gonna do one more. Oh, you have one?
No, I'm not that funny. But I do have, we are going to make a special presentation while we're waiting. Can we have Mr. Utah, Kevin Tao, come on up here for me, please? And can we have a Tao, the entire Tao family, come with him just for a minute, please? You know, the kids. Come on up. I see my girls get come out, and I think, oh no, Jacqueline's got her black jacket on, and I see Jill, get your jacket off. So they know how Mama likes it. Well, I wanted to invite my family up because if you followed anything I've done this year, you know, I've been busy. I feel like they have been such a big part of this. We are actually missing two of our boys are at BYU Hawaii, so they're not here with us, and I really miss them and wish they could be here with us as well. But they have been so supportive of me this year. Tucker has, he loves to tell his friend, call me Mrs. Utah in front of his friends, and he tried to sell my autograph cards. And Tegan has just been an angel. He's given me not one problem this whole year and has done everything that I've asked him to do when I ask him to help me. And I'm so thankful. And Jacqueline and Jillian, my sister, sent me a text message today with a picture that they put of the girls and I on there, and they said, and she said, your girls came at the right time. And I had four boys first, and I thought, I never imagined myself not having any girls, but then it was boy and boy and boy. And finally, when I was pregnant my fifth time, we had a mural being painted, and I didn't know what I was having. And I told the guy, just go ahead and paint five boys. And so I had to get the little pink paint out and change the baby into a pink outfit, put a bow in her hair. Because I wasn't sure I was going to get a girl, but I am so glad that I got the experience of having both my boys and girls, and I wanted to present my girls with something. Boys, well, I'll have to take you out on a date or something. So All Things Queen, Dina Carter donated dolls for the next Utah 2019, and I got these for my girls to give them so they could always remember. Today, Jill looked at me and she goes, Mom, I don't really want you to not be Mrs. Utah anymore, and with tears in her eyes, and I said, but now I get to be your mommy. Lastly, last year, Mr. Utah, got up and he gave advice to all the husbands, and it was pretty cute. So we couldn't really follow that act. But Kevin had one advice that he said he would share, and it was just don't say no. If things don't go the way she wants it to, you do
do not want it to be your fault.
So, I got my Mr. Utah a sash and wanted a sash this year because he was amazing and supportive. And this year, we will be married for 25 years in July.
So it, honestly, I thank you, but all of this is not, I drive it, it's my heart, but it's all of these women that continue to dream it, inspire it, move on. And now with my co-director, Jennifer, we continue to build the foundation after 24 years of producing this pageant. And for that, I will always, always be grateful. And I thank you all for being here.
Like we have our top five. So, let's welcome all of our contestants back to the stage, please, ladies. Further their platform for the remainder of the year. Each of them have discovered the power of the sash and will continue to make our state a great place to live. Now, the top five contestants in no particular order are Mrs. Salt Lake City. Thank you, ladies. stage with me, please.
John's my son. Thanks. I appreciate that. Yeah. So take a walk with me, Jim, here. Now, you and I have known each other for a long time, right?
That's no shame.
Yeah, like a whole lifetime. Like half, like some of these girls' lifetimes. Like really, for real. and so you have helped me out so many times in a pinch. You're going to help me out again. So yeah, you're going to hold the ball. Soraya, hi. How do you feel? Awesome. So I'm going to have you take a question out of that bowl and hand it to me. Thank you. And I'm going to read it, and then I'm going to give you the mic, and you're going to answer me. Okay? Tell us about your dream job.
My dream job is what got me here today, is to be a motivational speaker for our youth. And the reason why this is my dream job is because I feel like empowering our youth will eliminate a lot of issues that we have today. If we can start with empowerment, they'll be working for their passions. They'll be too bored to bully each other. They will be working on themselves instead of being depressed. It'll help them. So, brain fart. But that's it.
Thanks. Thanks. All right, Becky, let's see it. This is Cash Valley, let's see it. Now, as a busy wife and mother, you know this, that finding balance is often hard. How do you find balance?
Honestly, I am extremely busy. I teach probably 30 classes a week to children and to adults. The best way I found balance is to trust in my Heavenly Father. He takes care of my family when I'm gone. He takes care of me.
So I want to point something out. I pointed this out last year, but I think it bears repeating. If you ever really love your lady, guys, have her favorite dress sewn with pockets. Life change. Okay, Rochelle. Mrs. Utah County.
I'm rooting against all these women.
All of us experience setbacks. What do you do to bounce back from yours?
I've absolutely had setbacks. One of the things that I do is I take time with my family and I spend time with my husband, and we go up into the Utah mountains and we enjoy camping, we enjoy roasting hot dogs and spending time together as a family. But it hasn't always been that way. And the reason it hasn't always been that way is because I am a survivor of child sexual abuse. I have a son who is a survivor of child sexual abuse. I have a sister who's also a survivor. And I have a mother who's also a survivor. I want you to know that I'm so passionate about this cause, but I want it to change in our state. Utah has the 8th highest rate of child sexual abuse in the nation. It's not okay, it's not acceptable, and I want all of you, I invite you to join me. And how you can do that is you can contact your local elementary and junior high school and invite Prevent Child Abuse Utah in to teach prevention. And I'd also invite you to come online and take our training and so that you can become educated as a parent. But the most important thing that we should all be concerned with is the lifelong impact on a child and the suffering of innocent souls. That should motivate all of us, even when we have difficult days, to want to be better and to do more for our children. Thank you. Thanks for coming. What do you feel is your greatest accomplishment? Let's try that again. What do you feel is your greatest accomplishment to date?
My greatest accomplishment to date is my two children that are sitting over there watching me proudly and seeing me live my dream up on stage where I can share my message to other people, but also to them, especially to them. They are my greatest accomplishment. Thank you.
there's a lot of questions in there. Okay, if you could go back in time and change one thing in your life, what would it be?
Well, I think, you know, that's a lot of reason of why our platform got started was just looking back on our life. We haven't spent enough time serving others, and so we decided that we need to make that change today and now, and there's no, it's never too late to do that. No regrets.
Awesome. Thank you, Nicole. All right. I will take the chalice of life.
Thank you, Jen. Saved us from more dad jokes. In just a few moments, we will have a new Mrs. Utah and will crown our Miss Utah for America. Judges, not ready yet? Okay. You need a long time. Okay. Do we have the projector working? Thank you, ladies. We've had some technical difficulties with the projector. So right now, someone from tech back there, let me know if we've got that working yet. Well, in that case, Robin, would you like to come out and talk to us about how you have worked, and how with your work with your nonprofit, the Wolfpack. Do you come out here?
Now she is joined by a little go-getter, Jennifer Hunsaker.
I love both of you so very much. The 2018 pageant was the beginning of a dream. While training, I gave the competition 100%. But little did I know the wonderful journey I was about to embark on. Hearing my name called was a thrill like I've never experienced. Having my friends and family there to share that special moment made it all the better. I love the selfies with my boys and the hugs from my girls and the way that my husband and I looked at each other with a look that said, we did it. Because it took Team Utah. And then to bring,
because it took Team Towel.
And then to bring everything full circle was the wonderful experience of stepping on the Mrs. America stage and competing. It was a once-in-a-lifetime experience with gifts and fine dining every night. We worked hard on choreography and prepping for the show during the days and glammed up and were treated like royalty at night. David and Elaine Marmel were wonderful hosts and have worked so hard to create an organization to empower women. It was an amazing feeling to hear Mrs. Utah called into the top 15 and then again in the top 6. Living that experience was a dream come true. It was so special to have my family and friends there. My sister Paula even brought my sweet mama's watch. Of course, my best friend Joanne, who was always there for me, was grinning ear to ear. Thank you for all of your love and support. This would not have been possible without my wonderful sponsors. Aesthetica kept me glowing. Sierra West was an amazing supporter who donated strands and pearls for my farewell, supported my movie, and sponsored me at Mrs. America. Andy Andrews donated 52 of my favorite books, The Butterfly Effect, to give as contestant gifts. Mardell Photography donated the beautiful portrait on the front cover of the program book. Monet sponsored my trip to Mrs. America. Glam Squad of Arizona helped me get the most gorgeous wardrobe for Mrs. America. All Things Queen donated a beautiful queen doll, and Anytime Fitness donated a year membership to the Mrs. Utah 2019. A special thanks to Sam's Club Jordan, Nothing But Cakes, at Lehigh, Texas Roadhouse for helping me with events. Thank you, Whimsy Park City, and for dressing me like a queen, and thank you to Sterling Haynes for being a costume extraordinaire and being such a wonderful support to me at Mrs. America. Thank you to Scott Robert Lynn, Panoptic Chopsticks, Vintage Creek Photography. Thank you for all of your help. Last but not least, thank you, Alicia Green, for coaching me and for being such a great support. Thank you also to Lucas for helping me with this film and to show this. This year has been full of opportunities to work on my platform team, Suicide Prevention. Suicide is the number one cause of death in our state, ages 11 to 17. There were so many events that I was able to be a part of and support the cause. I'm a member of the State Suicide Coalition, American Foundation for Suicide Prevention, and I'm a trained facilitator in QPR. I have had several speaking engagements, served on suicide prevention panels, had a team walk for Out of the Darkness, and participated in a number of wellness fairs. Utah passed 11 new bills to aid in suicide prevention, and I was honored to be present for that signing. The thing I was the most excited about was the nonprofit that I started called the Wolf Pact. It teaches positive life skills to our teens and help them become kind and inclusive, but also resilient and secure. I am grateful for the incredible people I met and the one-on-one conversations I was able to have with people to hear their stories and share my personal story. Lastly, to Team Tao, you are my rock, you are my everything. I love you more than you will ever know. You have and always will be my wife. I want to give a special thanks to my sweet husband, Kevin. This summer we celebrate 25 years of marriage. Thank you, Kevin, for supporting me this year and for never saying no. And for being my Mr. Utah. Then it says, I think the picture of me carrying you off, you carrying me off into the sunset says it all. But lastly is the thing I want to do, and I'm sorry I read that, but it was important to me to thank everyone. It was supposed to be entertained with pictures. But what I'd like to do is, if you are a woman who lives in Utah, could you please stand? Okay, so my last thing was is when I had my farewell, my send-off party for Mrs. America, and my girlfriends came, there were so many of them there. And as I looked at them, I realized this is what it's all about. These ladies are all Mrs. Utah. You are all Mrs. Utah. You wear an invisible crown of kindness, service, gratitude, love, sacrifice, and on. So the way my film was supposed to end was we all said, Utah women rock, so I'd like everyone in this auditorium to join me on three saying Utah women rock. Ready? One, two, three. Utah women rock!
Exceptional job representing our state this year. Now, let's welcome back to the stage our contestants.
I know it right. final outcome of what is happening. But we do want to recognize the hard work that these ladies have put into this whole experience. Our first award is indicative of the amount of community support this contestant was able to rally in the form of ad pages and has no bearing on the overall selection of Mrs. Utah. Your Mrs. Utah America advertising award goes to Soraya Garfield.
Kennedy was well known for her smile as she fought juvenile Batten's disease, a rare degenerative disorder that took her life in 2014. Still, her infectious smile is what we remember for, is what she is remembered for by friends, family members, and even strangers who watched her and her story play out in the movie Love, Kennedy. The Kennedy Hansen Most Beautiful Smile Award goes to Mrs. Ogden, Jennifer Seigel. Thank you, our audience, family, and friends. And in your generosity, we have raised $1,464. And our winner in the state costume competition is Soraya Garfield. Rochelle Rutherford. Mrs. Lehigh, Nicole Hansen. And one more before we get to our final results. Best in the evening gown goes to Mrs. Riverton, Alicia Skaggs.
Top five, please step forward. Before we make the final announcements, I need to remind you that we have a little bit of official business we need to take care of with our judges and the official photographers. Please don't come up to the stage until after that's completed and they've instructed that you can do so. Thank you. Now. Okay. 1 minute. Hear more dad jokes? We'll spare you dad jokes. We ready?
Go!
All right. Let's get that drum roll again. Our fourth runner-up is Mrs. Salt Lake City, Soraya Garvey. Third runner-up is Mrs.
Mrs. Lehigh, Nicole Hansen. The second runner-up is, before we announce, I'm joking. The second runner-up is Mrs. Cache Valley, Becky Hurst. Of the first runner-up. Should for any reason Mrs. Utah is unable to fulfill her obligation, the first runner-up will assume her title and position. Now, our first runner-up, Mrs. Utah County, Rochelle Rutherford. Thank you.